Thank you to Wondrium for supporting PBS.
70 million years ago, a chicken-sized dinosaur roamed what's now Mongolia. Today, we call it Mononychus, and it was a little over a meter long and light-bodied thanks to its hollow bones. It was probably covered with shaggy feathers, and each of its stubby arms ended in just one functional claw. Now, Mononychus was a theropod, a group of dinosaurs famous for being fierce predators. Picture T-Rex or a Velociraptor. But those short arms with their single claws might point to a pretty different lifestyle for this animal. We often think of dinosaurs as either preying on other dinos or mammals, or as plant eaters. But in ecosystems today, those aren't the only two options. So why would we expect dinosaurs to have only been carnivores or herbivores, with the occasional omnivore thrown in the mix? Well, it looks like Mononychus and its relatives might have carved out their own ecological niche, one that only really became possible with the rise of social insects like ants and termites in the Cretaceous period. Because some paleontologists think these dinosaurs were specialized insect eaters. And the origin and spread of social insects would not only push these dinos towards a new diet, it would also come with a surprising consequence. Instead of getting bigger, like many other theropods in the Cretaceous, these dinos shrunk. Mononychus belonged to a group of dinosaurs called the Alvarosaurs, which are thought to have originated in Asia and would ultimately include 21 species over time. They first appeared in what's now China during the late Jurassic period, about 160 million years ago. And they were already small compared to most other theropod dinosaurs. Most of the Alvarosaurs we found weighed less than 50 kilograms. But the earliest members of this group looked pretty different from Mononychus. They had longer, chunkier forearms and teeth that were specialized for eating meat. One of these early Alvarosaurs was Haplochirus. It could reach a little over 2 meters long and weigh 41 kilograms on average, about the weight of a large dog, like a male German Shepherd. With its long legs and long forearms with 3 clawed fingers on each hand, Haplochirus could chase down and grab prey, but its skull features point to a relatively weak bite, so Haplochirus might have already been feeding on smaller prey than many of its theropod cousins. And in the same area lived Arun. It also had 3 claws on each hand and more finely serrated teeth. We've even found a third Alvarosaur from this same formation, dating to around the same time as the other two. While it's clear that Alvarosaurs were already diverse during the late Jurassic, they were all probably carnivores, like most other theropods. They just seemed to be after smaller prey. And in the early Cretaceous period, their evolution would take an interesting turn. Beginning around 130 million years ago, we find 2 more Alvarosaurs in China. They were probably smaller than Haplochirus, but not tiny, and they still had 3 claws on their hands. And one of these dinos had an enlarged thumb with an extra stout claw, dwarfing the other 2 shorter fingers. Paleontologists aren't sure what they ate, as their forearms were in between those of their carnivorous ancestors and the later specialized insectivores. But they did have 2 enlarged muscle attachment areas, one on their humerus and one on their ulna, that are similar to what we see in digging mammals today. These might have helped them make powerful arm movements. Paleontologists have ruled out burrowing, though, because their forearms were too short and their hind limbs were too long for a burrower. Instead, they were probably used for digging into harder surfaces, maybe taking the first step towards foraging for insects. These 2 dinosaurs fill the gap in the fossil record between their late Jurassic ancestors and the late Cretaceous Alvarosaurs, and their transitional features hint at what was to come. By the late Cretaceous, Alvarosaurs had dispersed to other continents, and that's when we see another major change in their anatomy. These dinosaurs were shrinking in body size and losing their smaller fingers altogether. Around 86 million years ago, Alvarosaurus lived in what's now Argentina alongside other members of its family that had radiated in South America. And the whole group is named after this species because it was the first one discovered. Alvarosaurus had tiny arms and just 1 functional clawed finger. While there is some debate about it, paleontologists think that Alvarosaurus was an insectivore that used its finger claw to rip into logs in search of termites. And overall, Alvarosaur body size dropped dramatically from the Jurassic to the late Cretaceous. The ancestral Jurassic Alvarosaurs in China are estimated to have averaged 23 kilograms in body mass. By 85 million years ago, these dinosaurs averaged less than 5 kilograms, and most were less than 2 kilograms. And those second and third fingers had all but disappeared on many species, including Alvarosaurus in Argentina and Mononychus in Mongolia, leaving just 1 functional, large clawed finger. Not only that, but in Mononychus, the carnivorous teeth had been replaced by tiny, simple teeth, like those of some ant-eating mammals today, including aardvarks. So by the late Cretaceous, the alvarosaurs had miniaturized while evolving stubby front arms with a single clawed finger and simple teeth. But why? Their shrinking happened really quickly by evolutionary standards, a threefold decrease in size over just 25 million years. And it's the opposite of what happened in many other groups of dinosaurs in the Cretaceous. They all got bigger by orders of magnitude, not smaller. For example, the tyrannosaurids outgrew their competition and became apex predators. The only other group of dinosaurs known to have shrunk in size are those from the lineage that evolved into birds. So what pushed the alvarosaurs towards developing smaller body sizes? Well, a study published in 2021 proposed that it was the transition to eating insects that shrunk them down and drove the adaptations in their hands, claws, and teeth. When flowering plants arose and started to spread during the Cretaceous, it spawned an explosion of insects, including social ones like termites and ants. Paleontologists call this period of increased diversification of life on land the Cretaceous Terrestrial Revolution. Termites evolved from cockroaches in the early Cretaceous, but based on fossil evidence, their social lifestyle started to flourish later as part of this revolution. And ants also got a boost during the rise of flowering plants. Ants first show up as fossils in the early Cretaceous, but they radiated and became more abundant between 160 million years ago. And these thriving social insect colonies that appeared in the mid to late Cretaceous might have made a new lifestyle possible for some dinosaurs. The shrinking of the alvarosaurs lines up neatly with the diversification of ants, termites, and bees. Not only that, but as they got smaller, they split into even more species than ever before. And their short clawed forelimbs became adapted to dig into wood to find ants or termites underneath. For example, one species from Mongolia about 80 million years ago is pegged as a termite specialist that dug into nests based on its short arms and broad flat hands tipped with a single claw. And another species that lived in Canada 68.5 million years ago looked like it was adapted to feed on wood nesting termites using its strong but short arms to dig them out of logs. Trace fossils of termite borings were also found in the same formation. It isn't just their hands and arms that give us evidence of this changing diet either. Other features provide support for these dinosaurs as insect eaters, including their long, narrow jaws. Many ant-eating mammals today, including pangolins and armadillos, have long, narrow snouts that they can stick into insect nests. And the alvarosaurs seem to have had weak jawbones, probably because chewing becomes less important when you're eating ants. Also, like today's social insect specialists, alvarosaurs had no teeth in the front of their mouth. This arrangement allows the tongue to flick out and return covered with ants or termites. So while the first alvarosaurs were carnivores, the rise of social insects during the Cretaceous Terrestrial Revolution seems to have pushed them into a new niche, one that was new for them and new for dinosaurs. They evolved into smaller-bodied insectivores with delicate jaws, short limbs, and single claws. Their hands became similar to those of anteaters and other insect-eating mammals today, which have an enlarged finger with a pick-like claw to break open social insect nests. And alvarosaurs may have reduced competition with other theropod dinosaurs that had gotten bigger and become apex predators by becoming insect eaters, which is pretty incredible when you think about it. Insects going from a solitary life to living in organized social colonies is by itself a major transition in the history of life on our planet. And for these tiny creatures to have influenced the evolution of a group of dinosaurs is definitely worthy of wonder. And while the alvarosaurs wouldn't survive the end Cretaceous extinction event, their new lifestyle would live on in the many insect-eating birds and mammals that are part of our world today. Thanks to our main digit eontologists this month, Chase Archambault, Ashley Yakubak, Colton, Mikhail Afraidy, Annie and Eric Higgins, John Davidson Inc., Jake Hart, and Sean Dennis. By becoming an eonite at patreon.com/eons, you can get fun perks like submitting a joke for us to read, like this one from Cassie W. What do you call a dinosaur in boots and a cowboy hat? Tyrannosaurus Tex!
Thank you to Wondrium for supporting PBS. The folks behind the great courses are making moves. Enter Wondrium, a video streaming service with all of the content from the Great Courses Plus. Subscribers can access a library of lectures, a curated collection of short and long form videos, tutorials, how-tos, travelogues, documentaries, and more. Topics range from science, math, history, and literature to everyday experiences, how to cook, digital photography, or training a new dog. For example, in The Scientific Wonder of Birds, Dr. Bruce E. Fleury covers topics like the origin of flight, how birds navigate over long distances, and of course, the connections between birds and their extinct dinosaur ancestors. To learn more about Wondrium and to check out our trial, click on the link in the description below.
And as always, thanks for joining me in the Constantine Haase studio. Subscribe at youtube.com/eons for fabulous fossils.